kind of thinking the International would be better because it's a smaller vehicle. And I couldn't remember if there were any winch points up here or not. Let me push. There we go. I think we got it now. Went around there. Oh, so that's exactly how you got through the first time? Yeah, just need a little help from friends and just over at one little area needed a little boost. And now this truck has an advantage over the Action because if I flip it, I have an autonomous winch. I've also got to get the Action back out of here. And there were not a lot of turnaround points. So for anybody that doesn't know what I was talking about when I said the submarine base, this is a submarine base. And can't go out too far on it because in the scout vehicles it'll damage them. That ice flips up. But right on the other side of that little landing there is water going through there, and it's too deep to take anything through. Which is why you gotta go up and around. But it leads into the submarine base. Oh. You're not gonna fool me. And there's another mission here. Taking this hut out of here. And I tried every way I could think of to get that out of here. I brought a trailer down here. I tried to load it up on a truck. Could not get it to do anything. And then it dawned on me it has skids. So all you have to do is attach a winch to it. And you can pull it. Not with this truck, but with a bigger truck. So that opens up all of that. And like I said before, first time I was on this map, I was thinking the bomber was on this map. So I searched all of this area. I took the Tatran up in here and drove all through that area, which actually is a way that you can get out of here. You can go up through here and drive through here, but you'll need the Tatran to do it. Anything else just bogs down in the snow. But that's a good way to get out of here. And here's where I was talking about the submarine base. So So that's where the subs went in, and this is too much to cross. Which, if we had a truck that would lay a bridge, that would be awesome. That is definitely someplace I would put a bridge. At least till I completed the two missions out here. And plus, you could use a bridge out here where the ice is thin. We're at all through here where the ice is thin and you can't cross it, or right here. Set up a bridge right there. That would be nice. If anybody has a developer's ear, a bridge layer. And it would also help on Imandra. You could lay a bridge across some of the ice. Or gaps in the ice. Gotta take it easy. For that lead finger of mine, because that kind of stuff can happen. And no winch points. Alright, dude, you gotta come up that hill a little more. Unless you've got a longer winch. You have a longer winch. Almost. See, it lit up for a second. Truck up there. Easy way to turn it around. There we go. Turning it around this way. Try it a new way. Oh, we'll let me get the back end. I'm gonna slide it around. Just a little bit. Almost like a professional. I don't know what kind of professional, but so as long as I don't flip both of these at the same time, I should be all right. And if I flip them both at the same time, I'm going to call it a night. But I think we're okay. No problem. Also, you got to scout through solo. Yeah, I am a professional Mr. Tippy Flipper. I've got a lot of experience at it. Okay, so I do have this area up here that I need to get to, and I've got that truck to discover. Gotta go up that road, which is not preferable, and I'm gonna have to do it anyway. I'm not mistaken, that is not a nice road. It's deep snow and swamp. So if I can get away with it, I'm just going to take one truck out there. Leave the other one back just in case. And I think I'll leave the scout. Save a little bit on some gas. Oh, and I forgot about the rock minefield. Alright, so not so bad so far. I forgot this thing doesn't turn very well. So, see where I'm at. And so we're here at North Camp, so I need to go up. Yeah, I thought about cutting cross country, but I'll stick to this path. Do it. That flipped me over. This is the muddy part. Out of my engine. I think through here would be the best one. Yeah, I can get a better angle at it. Right there, the suspension upgrade would have hurt me. I may have tipped it over. Oh, come on. Yeah, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. Right. Crash through these trees. Should be alright. Sunsets fast here in Russia. Running out of gas. Now I wish I had the scout with me to fix the engine. But I think the scout would have fared much worse, because this does sit higher than where I got in there. Done a lot more damage to the motor. Should be able to drive on this. But I will stick over here. Whoa. Alright, where's that truck? There it is. And I need to head out that road. There's the truck. The ice? I think I did. So, could you help me? I bought some boards at the metro station, but I got stuck and ruined half my vehicle. Could you get me to the mechanic, please? Be a friend, okay? I can do that. Even though he's not going to give me the truck. I believe I will probably break through that ice. Nope, I can drive on that one. So I can climb out. Yeah. I don't remember what's up the end of this road. I think whatever it is not worth it. Or maybe it is. And that is one of the places I have to visit. So I can't drive into there. But I do have it opened up. If I drive into there, I'm completing a mission. Part of one. Stay out of the blue. Okay, so that looks good there. I need to come back down and go up this road. And Tatron would be so nice now. Like a big tree, but I don't want to punch it too hard. There we go. Alright, so straight through there. Get our next road. And that's one over there. I don't remember if the maintenance trailer on this map is mine or it's a mission. I think it's mine. One over at North Camp. Let's look down. So that one right there. Go visit it. Mud pit. And snow pit. Take your pick. You can drive through the mud and go nowhere, you can drive through the snow and go nowhere. Stay up here a moment. And I see a guard tower. Is the old helicopter in. And it has this container over here. I'm going to have to come and get. And I've tried to drive up the stairs, you can't. Not even in Little Scout. Okay, so that's opened up and need to head back down this way. Visit the ice once more. And that should take care of that. Alright, I think I got all the roads over here, but this one. That one heading up there, and the one from here around. So now I need to come up in here. And I think I'm going to wait on the scout to come up here and give me some repairs. And let's see if the scout come up here. Go up to the top of the mountain. Let's see if you can do it. As I said, I'm really surprised that these trucks are actually doing this on this map. Seeing how they're not upgraded very much. I remember bringing the Lodestar up into some of these areas and it just would not go. Maybe where these are lighter. Need to refuel. Reduce some of the weight on the top. Maybe it won't tip as much. Be interesting to come back over here next time I'm over here, and because I have better tires, I have mud tires, to see how mud tires do over here. Because that's what I had on the scout vehicles when I ran them here, were the mud tires, and they just would not go anywhere. Maybe that was a problem. Come on, that. It's nothing for a big, strong truck like you. So I gotta go down that way a little bit and come back up here. So I think I'm gonna back down that way. So I don't have to worry about turning around. And let's see how far I have to go. Not very far. Probably about right there. Sliver. Oop, wrong one. But it's not too bad. That should have it. But then again, I am going downhill. Yep. Let's get back uphill. Yeah, still not too bad. And there's like a hole there. And the road continues to here. And I need to go straight down the mountain. Uh-oh. I did not see that hole. I did see that one next to me. Just wanted to see if that was any better. And I don't think it is. About the same. Alright, made it through. Following the path that I took the Acti on, and I don't know if that's a good idea or not. But it worked out. Okay. So that takes care of all of this area, except for over in here, which I've got to drive up on the mountain here. First, I have to get both trucks around the cliff here. And then one of them's got to go down here. Back up, and I think there's something over here. It might be a mission here, or that might be a location that I have to get. Yeah, there's my secure container over there now. I discovered it. Oop, wrong truck. And let's refuel you. Nope. Scout still has, well, if I'm gonna do it, let's go ahead and refuel those tanks too. Do it with the actor. A little further up here. 56 gallons left, so I got. Take a second here, and I need to check MapRunner, because if that is a trailer that I can keep, it will have a dollar value attached to it. The loaf. Oh, okay. Sorry, I was looking at something. It showed the showed a loaf on here. I didn't remember ever getting a loaf. Okay, find out where I'm at. Vehicles. That's what I wanted to put. So if you don't know about MapRunner, check out MapRunner. Yes, it is a one that I can have. It has an estimated value of $6,400. So MapRunner is a great tool if you're stuck on something. You need to find like where a mission starts, where to accept a mission. Or you can see the roads, you can see upgrades, things like that. I don't use it very often, but I do like the fact that it will show you vehicles and show you trailers. And if it has a dollar value associated with the trailer, then it is yours. It's not a mission trailer. So this one is mine. Which means I can do some repairs, and if I wanted to, I could sell this trailer. But I don't think I want to do that. What I want to do is put it out on the ice. And I can't do it with this truck. Dang. But I might be able to get it up to the trailer. Get it up to the north camp where it can do me some more good. If I can get it out here. I don't think this truck can pull it out of here. Yeah, so I can sell it. Burton says I can sell it, it belongs to me. And yes, there is a trailer store up there, but I don't, if I can hold on to it, I want to hold on to it, because I can also pull it over to Imandra, where I can use it until I've used up all the repair points, and then sell it when it is bone dry. you're not gonna let me do it all. I'm going to need a bigger truck. Yep. Which is fine, I will go with the original plan. Bring one of the bigger trucks over here and pick it up. There's all right, maybe I can reach, yeah, I can reach the trees over here now. And once I get up here to more solid ground, should actually go on its own power. Yeah. That's what I like to see. Alright, we'll get up top of the hill and then go get the International. It's not a road, is it? Nope. Hillside. There you go, good truck. I went to work today and parked my truck and got out of it and went around to the passenger side and got my stuff out of it, and one of my coworkers parked next to me. When I opened the passenger door, I realized that my dash cam, I did not unplug it. I have to unplug it out of the cigarette lighter. And she was getting out of her truck, or getting out of her car. And I said, goodbye, have a nice day. And she looked at me, she said, what? I said, sorry, I'm talking to my truck. Because every time I unplug my dash cam says, goodbye. So I always tell my truck goodbye and have a nice day. It's the little things you have fun with during your day. Can't have fun, there's no sense in playing. sure I get the furthest tree out. My wife told me that the first few times that her Jeep did that, because on my truck, my cigarette lighter is constant power, so I've got to unplug even when I turn the ignition off, take the keys out, still has constant power going to the cigarette lighter. But her Jeep, when she turns the engine off, she, you know, takes all power, all the accessories, including the cigarette lighter. She said the first few times that her Jeep told her goodbye scared the crap out of her. She thought somebody was in the Jeep with her. And I need to hook a mouse up to my Xbox. I'm kind of curious if I've got a mouse hooked to it, if I can use that to hook up to, use that for the winch, hook up to the tree that I want. I need to try that. Probably do it tomorrow. Too lazy to do it today. Been a long day. Alright, now remember you tree. Ah, it did it to me again. Right, but I can get around it now. I always have problems when I try to go over that rock there. Found that it's just easier for me to get around here and then gun it and hope for the best. Alright, this one made it. And it's got... how many repair points does it have? Full repair points. So if the Acteon can't make it and I fall over the cliff, then I can actually go down and repair it. At least some of it. But this truck's going to have no problem. Can you go up and around? I don't know. I think the developers would have thought of that and made it almost impossible. Put trees too close together. Which is one of the things I really like about the Yukon maps. They spread the trees out more so that you can actually go into the woods. Look at almost celebrated too early. All right. down this road. I get too greedy here. Nice and easy. Did I miss? I did miss the other road. Okay, so I think this is good enough for that one. Yep. And I need to go through here. Get over there. So when I come over, if I'm not doing any kind of hardcore mode where I have to do maps, complete regions before jumping to other regions, normally through there is where I'll bring the P-12, pull on a scout vehicle, and then the scout will come up this way and get the upgrade, and the P-12 will continue on down this way to get the 750. Especially if the P-12 is fully upgraded. And I've found that even with a maintenance add-on, with maintenance and fuel, P-12 usually does not have any issues getting the 750 and bringing it back out. Remember this. So here you don't take the road. Take the road, you're going to get stuck. This road is down in the shade there. Okay, so this was a flag. Right, so I don't want to hit that. And I have it opened up. Okay, back up the hill you go. level here. Flipping would be bad. But I'm so good at it. Alright, so I'm going to get this up here, and I am going to call it a night. So, appreciate you, all of y'all watching me on Twitch, and for those watching on YouTube, thank you also, and leave me some comments, and let me know how I'm doing, what I can do to improve, I would appreciate it, and, ooh, that's a nice view. That's pretty. And I will see y'all in the next episode. So until then, have a good one.